A Face in the Night by Ruskin Bond. It may give you some idea of rural humor if I begin this tale with an antidote that concerns me. I was walking alone through a village at night when I met an old man carrying a lantern. I found, to my surprise, the man was blind. "Old man," I asked, "if you cannot see, why do you carry a lantern?" "I carry this," he replied, "so that fools do not stumble against me in the dark." This incident has only a slight connection with the stories that follows, but I think it provides the right sort of tone and setting. Mr. Oliver, an Anglo-Indian teacher, was returning to his school late one night on the outskirts of the hill station of Shimla. The school was conducted on English public schools lines, and the boys, most of them well-to-do Indian families, wore blazers, caps, and ties. Mr. Oliver had been teaching in the school for several years. He is no longer there. The Shimla Bazaar, with its cinema and restaurant, was about 2 miles from the school, and Mr. Oliver, a bachelor, usually strolled into the downtown in the evening, returning after the dark, when he would take a shortcut through a pine forest. When there was a strong wind, the pine trees made sad, eerie sounds that kept most of people to the maintained road. But Mr. Oliver was not nervous or an imaginative man. He carried a torch on the night I write of. Its pale gleam, the batteries were running down, moved fitfully over the narrow forest path. When its flickering light fell on the figure of a boy who was sitting alone on a rock, Mr. Oliver stopped. Boys were not supposed to be out of the school after 7 p.m. and it was now well past 9. "What are you doing here, boy?" asked Mr. Oliver sharply, moving closer so that he could recognize the miscreant. But even as he approached the boy, Mr. Oliver sensed that something was wrong. The boy appeared to be crying. His head hung down. He held his face in his hand and his body shook convulsively. It was a strange, soundless weeping, and Mr. Oliver felt distinctly uneasy. "Well, what's the matter?" he asked, his anger giving the way to concern. "What are you crying for?" The boy would not answer or look up. His body continued to be racked with silent sobbing. "Come on, boy, you shouldn't be out there at this hour. Tell me the trouble. Look up." The boy looked up. He took his hand from his face and looked up at his teacher. The light from Mr. Oliver's torch fell on the face of the boy, if you call it a face. He had no eyes, ears, nose, or mouth. It was just a round, smooth head with a school cap on top of it. And that's where the story should end. As indeed it has. For several people who have had similar experiences and dropped dead of the heart attacks. But for me, Mr. Oliver, it did not end there. The torch fell from his trembling hand. He turned and scrambled down the path, running blindly through the trees and calling for help. He was still running towards the school building when he saw the lantern swinging in the middle of the path. Mr. Oliver had never been so pleased to see a night watchman. He stumbled up. The watchman, gasping for breath and speak incoherently. "What is it, Sahib?" asked the watchman. "Has been there an accident? Why you're running?" "I saw something horrible, a boy weeping in the forest, and he had no face."
"No face, Sahib?"
"No eyes, mouth, nothing."
"Do you mean it was like this, Sahib?"
asked the watchman and raised the lamp to his own face. The watchman had no eyes, no ears, no features at all, not even an eyebrow. The wind blew the lamp out, and Mr. Oliver had his heart attack.